ओके, गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स. सो स्टूडेंट्स, विदाउट वेस्टिंग टाइम आई वुड लाइक टू प्रोसीड विद द लास्ट चैप्टर. इन द लास्ट चैप्टर वी हैव स्टडीड अबाउट, आई हैव एक्सप्लेन्ड यू द स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ रेस्पिरेटरी सिस्टम. ओके, बिफोर प्रोसीडिंग आई वुड लाइक टू से यू दैट स्टूडेंट्स, आई अपलोड ऑल द डॉक्यूमेंट्स. सो वॉट यू डू ड्यूरिंग द क्लास आवर, यू अरेंज द डॉक्यूमेंट्स इन द करेक्ट ऑर्डर एंड देन प्ले द ऑडियो, बिकॉज ऑडियो इट इज एग्जैक्टली एक्सप्लेन्ड ऑन द बेसिस ऑफ द documents, so the things will become easier for you. Now children, what happens in respiration? When you breathe in air, the air, it goes to the nostrils. Nostrils filter the air because nostrils has air, hairs. So after nostrils, the air goes to the nasal chamber, then it comes to the pharynx. Pharynx is the region which is common both to food as well as to your, as well as to air. Then from pharynx, it passes to the larynx and then it enters in the trachea, the air. Now, my question is, anyone of you can answer using the microphone. My question is that why food, because pharynx is common to food also, air also, why food does not enter into the respiratory system? Why? Because digestive system also lies there. Digestive system is behind respiratory system. But why food does not enter in the respiratory system? Anyone can answer. Okay. Why it happens? Because the larynx has one valve or a covering, leaf-like covering, which is called as epiglottis. So when you swallow food, okay, all of you, you just touch the neck, don't press hardly, that portion you touch lightly and you try to swallow. You will find that this tracheal portion, it moves up. So while doing so, while swallowing, what happens while swallowing food, this neck portion or this trachea portion, it moves up and it gets closed by the epiglottis. Now, only passage left for the movement of food is digestive system. The food from the pharynx will go to the esophagus, stomach and so on. And here it passes through the larynx to the trachea. From the trachea, it will go to the bronchi. It will go to bronchioles and to the alveoli. Alveoli are very thin walled. Now, heart is also present here. It is present somewhat in the middle of the lungs. Now, what happens? The heart contains all the deoxygenated blood. It is brought to the heart. From the heart, the blood, deoxygenated blood, goes to the lungs. Now, what is deoxygenated? Deoxygenated blood is that blood where carbon dioxide is more as compared to oxygen. Now, what happens? From the body cells, carbon dioxide, in all the body cells, respiration takes place and carbon dioxide is released. This carbon dioxide gas is a waste gas. So this carbon dioxide gas, it mixes in the blood. Okay. And blood becomes deoxygenated. Means blood contains more carbon dioxide and less oxygen. Now this blood is called as deoxygenated blood and it goes to the heart. Okay, it comes to the right side of the heart. And from the heart, this deoxygenated blood goes to the lungs for oxygenation. And how it goes? In the blood vessels, because ours is a closed circulatory system. All the blood, it is not... It moves in a vessels which are called as the blood vessels. So I hope all of you have understood. So that deoxygenated blood, carbon dioxide will come in the blood and the blood will become deoxygenated. Deoxygenated only means that it has got higher concentration of carbon dioxide as compared to oxygen. Or we also call it as impure blood. But it does not mean that if it is deoxygenated blood, it contains waste material. No, deoxygenated blood only means कार्बन डाइऑक्साइड इज मोर, ऑक्सीजन इज लेस, बट इट मे कंटेन द यूजफुल एज वेल एज द वेस्ट मटेरियल. इट मे कंटेन फूड, इट मे कंटेन वेस्ट मटेरियल लाइक यूरिया, यूरिक एसिड एंड सो ऑन. एंड फ्रॉम द हार्ट इट गोज टू द लंग इन द ब्लड वेसल्स एंड नियर द लंग्स इट ब्रेक्स इन टू वेरी वेरी फाइन ट्यूब्स विच आर कॉल्ड एज कैपिलरीज. एंड दीज फाइन कैपिलरीज फॉर्म अ नेटवर्क अराउंड द alveoli. Now the walls of alveoli are also very thin, walls of capillaries are also very thin, so diffusion of gases can take place easily. So then what happens when you breathe in air? The air comes to the, it reaches the alveoli. Now this air will have more of oxygen because environmental air or atmospheric air has more oxygen. So this air which you breathe from outside, it enters into the lungs, it reaches the alveoli, and the air contains more oxygen and it contains less carbon dioxide. I told you the capillaries form a network around the alveoli, network around the alveoli. Now what will happen? It forms the network of fine tubes around the alveoli. Now what will happen? These capillaries or these fine tubes are called as capillaries. Now the deoxygenated blood comes in these capillaries. Okay, and these capillaries, what they are doing? They are forming a network around the alveoli. And what is present in these capillaries which are forming a network around the alveoli? It contains the deoxygenated blood. And from where this deoxygenated blood is coming? It is coming via heart to the lungs. And this deoxygenated blood is the blood which contains carbon dioxide secreted by the cells during respiration. So now what happens? The exchange of gases will take place because in alveoli air is present, air has got more oxygen. But in the capillaries, what is present? More of carbon dioxide is present and less of oxygen is present. So what will happen? The oxygen from the alveoli through the walls of the alveoli will move to the capillary or will move to the blood containing more of carbon dioxide due to higher concentration of oxygen in the alveoli air than in the carbon dioxide. So here the exchange of gases will take place. Oxygen from the air will go to carbon dioxide and carbon dioxide will go to the alveoli. And from alveoli, when you breathe out, what will happen? The air from the alveoli will go to the bronchioles, bronchi, trachea, and through nasal cavity and through the nostril it is expelled out, and this air contains more of carbon dioxide. I hope all of you have understood. Okay, now this is the, and when you breathe in air, what happens? More air goes inside the respiratory tract. What happens? The lungs bulges out. Okay, but the lungs, it moves out and it bulges out, and the diaphragm goes down. The size of the thoracic cavity is increased and lot of air it moves in. Exchange of gases takes place between the capillaries, between the gases flowing in the capillaries and the air. And after that, what will happen? The air is expelled out from the lungs. So in that case, when the air is expelled out, what happens? Now the air becomes less in the lungs. So what happens? The lungs, they come back to the original position. Diaphragm also come back to the original position, thereby reducing the size of the thoracic cavity. I hope everyone has understood this. And if anyone has any doubt, can clear by using the microphone. Okay. Now students, transportation. What do you understand by transportation? Okay, this is page 105, transportation. Children, what do you mean by in journal? If you have to transport things from one city to another or from one place to another, how you will carry the things, how you will transport the things? If you have to bring something from city to your homes, how you will bring? Anyone can answer? Anyone can use the microphone and answer by truck, bus, car. If and you have to take the things, transport the things from one city to another, then by train, by aeroplane. So these are called transport system. Why? Because they transport the thing from one place to another. But students, in our body also, the food, it has to reach to all the cells of the body. You know that living organisms are made up of cells. What are our body? It's the it contains large number of tissues and large number of different types of tissues. So now the useful material has to reach all the cells, and waste produced by the cell has to be removed. It needs to be removed. Now what to do? Medium which carries or transport these things? That medium is blood. Blood flows in our body. Blood carries food, waste material, carbon dioxide, oxygen gas, and transport from one end to the other end of the body. I hope all of you have understood. Okay, so students, first we will study the components of blood. You all know that In our body, blood flows in a vessels, in a tubes, which are called as blood vessels. I hope all of you have understood. Now, for components of blood, okay, you can see image 1, components of blood. Okay, now, children, blood, you can see in the image very nicely, blood consists of fluid part, which is called as plasma. It is shown by yellow color in image 1, that is composition of blood. Then it contains three different types of cells: red blood cells, white blood cells, and platelets, that you can very clearly see in the image or the picture or the diagram which is there in the document. So the blood, it is divided into two parts. Blood has two parts. The fluid part is the plasma and it contains cell. Now cells are of three different types: RBCs, WBCs, and platelets. Plasma. Now I told you that substances are moved in our body with the help of blood, or blood carries the substances. Now in the blood, which thing carries the substances? It is the plasma. Plasma transport food, carbon dioxide, nitrogenous wastes, and cells. First, red blood cells. Children, red blood cells are red due to the presence of a substance or a pigment, I would rather like to say, hemoglobin. Red color of the blood is only due to the presence of hemoglobin, and this hemoglobin has got great affinity for oxygen. So this hemoglobin, it transports oxygen. It carries oxygen by forming a compound, oxyhemoglobin, because hemoglobin has a great affinity or attraction towards oxygen. So oxygen and hemoglobin combine together to form oxyhemoglobin, and in this way the red blood cells carry hemoglobin. In this way the red blood cells carry oxygen. White blood cells, you know, white blood cells kills foreign body, thereby preventing us from infections. Platelets, children, platelets helps in the clotting of blood. Okay, I hope all of you have understood this thing, and you just see the image also nicely. Now students, I told you that things are carried from one place to another place by transport system, that is truck, bus, aeroplanes and all. But children, if the pump of these things, transport system, if the engine of these things, car, bus, doesn't work, what will happen? Will they move? If they have a defective engine, no, they will not move. Then what is the work of the engine? It is providing them, engine is providing them force. That is why they are able to move. In our body, blood is like a transport system which transfers or transports substances to different parts of the body. But this blood also needs force. And which is that organ which is providing force to the blood? It is the heart. Heart is the organ which provides force to the blood to flow. Therefore, heart is called as pump of the body. Now, before starting with the structure and functioning of heart, I would like to tell you another important thing, that is the blood flows in our body in vessels, in tubes, which are called as blood vessels. Children, blood vessels are of three types in our body. Arteries, which are thick-walled, veins, they are thin-walled, and capillaries, they are very, very thin-walled, very fine tubes. Children, arteries carries oxygenated blood, except pulmonary artery. Pulmonary artery, it carries deoxygenated blood and it originates from the heart. Veins carries deoxygenated blood, except pulmonary vein. Pulmonary vein carries oxygenated blood. Artery, color of artery is red and color of vein is bluish. Arteries carries the blood away from the heart. Arteries carries the oxygenated blood away from the heart. Vein brings the deoxygenated blood to the heart. Arteries have thick walled, veins have thin walled. Arteries are deep rooted or deep seated. They are inside this thing. And veins, they are on the surface. All of you just try to see in your hand. You can see large number of bluish things. This thing, blue lines you can see. Actually, they are the veins. Okay. Now, I would also like to say you, I would also like to tell you one very important thing. Children, arteries, they divide to give capillaries. They divide to form capillaries. Capillaries, they join to form veins. Actually, in the arteries, oxygenated blood is flowing. When these arteries present near the cell, these arteries, they divide to form fine tubes called as capillaries, which are thin walled. Okay, and what happens? Exchange of gases takes place through capillaries. Now, arteries contains oxygenated blood. So, if arteries are dividing into capillaries, the blood will flow in the capillaries, and in the capillaries, the blood will be oxygenated. Means it will have more oxygen and less carbon dioxide. And if in the cell, respiration has taken place, so carbon dioxide gas is produced. So, in the cell, there is more carbon dioxide and less oxygen. And in the blood, which is present in the capillary, the oxygen is more, carbon dioxide is less. So what will happen? Oxygen being at the higher concentration in the capillaries, then cell will move from the blood present in the capillary to the cell. Means here diffusion, movement of the blood will take place, because capillaries contains more oxygen and in the cell oxygen is less. So, oxygen will move through the thin walls of the capillaries. Now, since respiration has taken place in the cell there is more carbon dioxide, and in the blood present in the capillary the carbon dioxide is less. So, the carbon dioxide will move from the cell to the blood which is present in the capillaries, and that blood will become deoxygenated. Means now that blood previously which was having more of oxygen and less of carbon dioxide, after exchange of gases will have more of carbon dioxide and less of oxygen. And then after exchange of gases takes place, these capillaries, they join to form veins. And these deoxygenated blood, it reaches the veins. And these veins actually carry the blood to the heart. All the veins, they join, rejoin, and they form two main veins which bring the blood to the right side of the heart. You can even see in the image. Image 2. You can check in image 2 also. So in image 2 also, that is only shown. You can see it. So children, now structure of heart. Now, heart is what? Heart is the pump of the body. Now the size of the heart is the fist size. Heart is divided first into two chambers, the right and the left. Children, the right side of the heart contains deoxygenated blood. Deoxygenated means more carbon dioxide as compared to oxygen. Deoxygenated does not mean that it will have more carbon dioxide and no oxygen. Deoxygenated means more carbon dioxide as compared to oxygen, means in that blood oxygen is also present, carbon dioxide is also present, but carbon dioxide is more. So right side of the heart contains deoxygenated blood and left side of the heart contains oxygenated blood. Oxygenated blood does not mean that it doesn't contain carbon dioxide. It contains carbon dioxide, it has oxygen also, but oxygen is much more as compared to carbon dioxide. Okay, so you can see in the image 3 that right side is shown with a blue color because it contains deoxygenated blood and deoxygenated blood is impure. I told you in the beginning also, because vein, they carry deoxygenated blood, that is why veins are blue in color. That is why they have shown right side of the heart with blue color and right side with the red color. Now each of this side, I told you heart is divided into two sides, right and the left, and again this right and the left side, again they are divided. So in total there are four chambers. Heart has four chambers, two upper chambers and two lower chambers. Children, upper chambers are called as atriums. You can see in the diagram, upper side, they are called as atrium or auricles. Another name is auricles. Right auricle which is present at the right side is called right auricle or right atrium, and the atrium or the auricle present on the left side is called as left or the left atrium or the left auricle. You can see children, it's shown by arrow. The lower chambers are called ventricles. The ventricle present on the right side is the right ventricle, and the ventricle present on the left side is the left ventricle. Just see the diagram or the image properly. Now children, Today we will study till here only. I will give you a short assignment, and all of you are expected to do this assignment now during the class hours.